coming on this morning. See, Scripture instructs us to count it pure joy when we go through various trials. We often find ourselves agreeing wholeheartedly with loud exclamations of amen. And then when the trials hit, we find ourselves asking why, or asking God to help us escape it. Paul and Silas are beautiful examples. They found themselves beaten severely and in prison for doing nothing wrong. And what was their response? Praise and worship at the top of their lungs. Yeah. The result? God sent an earthquake that not only broke off their chains, but the chains of every prisoner, and the complete redemption of the guard's entire household.
Yeah.
It's time to stop focusing on what's wrong with us and start focusing on what's right with God. In that perspective, we can worship in spirit and in truth, which releases God to move in epic proportions in and through us.
Okay, so I just have to repent right now. Yeah, I'm just gonna, that word right there was for me.
I'm repenting. I'm out in trial and I've been griping about it. Sorry, Lord. So, and it's just a minuscule trial, truly it is.
But it hit my heart. It hurt my heart. So just repent. Just telling you right now. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Get a new thought. That's what repentance is. Get a new thought. Think again. Change your perspective. Get a new thought. Guess about a new thought. Upgrade.
Amen.
There's reason to joy when we know that our perspective is not limited to what's wrong with us, but what's right with God. Because there's nothing wrong with God.
Leave it all behind.
says this. So bring me your heart, no matter how broken. Just come as you are, when your last prayer is spoken. Just rest in my arms and I can feel the change, my child. When you come to me, rest in my arms and mind, and feel the change of time. And come to the well. I want you to recognize he doesn't say, get yourself together and come to me. He says, just rest and I'll do the work. But your job is to rest. My job is to rest in his arms.
Leave it all behind.
Changes when we
receive it. Receive your love today. Say, I receive your love. I receive your love today. Thank you, Jesus, for giving the way for that to happen. Yes, Jesus, you love me. Thank you. Amen.
Tell her apart from anyone else was,
And the bad guys got there before the good guys, and they were going to kill her. She says it cut to this scene where all you could see was the heads of people, of the people, all those working in the camp, the slave camp. And suddenly the princess lifted her head and made eye contact with the ones who were out to kill her. And they instantly fell on their faces. Because in that culture that this was set in, royalty trumped all. Of course the good guys came and took out the bad guys and freed the princess. Yay! Royalty. And whether you're looking the enemy dead in the eye on your behalf or on someone else's behalf, he has to bow a knee, because what is in you is greater than him. He has to recognize royalty as what for what it is.
The name that's so much.
We lift you.